Thank you. Hi, I'm Shirmung. I'm a software developer at BarkBox in New York City, where we focus on creating products that help keep dogs happy and healthy. Speaking of dogs, this is a picture of my dog Smalltalk and me. This is a picture of me eating noodles. And this is a picture of Smalltalk eating noodles. Now that you know all about me, let's talk about type coercion in JavaScript. I've been programming predominantly with JavaScript over the past couple of years, and I've gotten pretty familiar with many of its quirks. So one of those quirks being type coercion. Today, I hope to provide you all with a better understanding of how exactly JavaScript converts between types and the various situations in which it performs type coercion. But let's back up. Let's talk about type conversion in general. So Wikipedia says that type conversion, otherwise known as typecasting or type coercion, is implicitly or explicitly changing an entity of one data type into another. So what does that mean more simply? That's taking a type, for example, an int, and converting it to another type, a string. So how does JavaScript handle type conversion? JavaScript is dynamically typed, as many of you know, which means that variable types are determined during script execution at runtime. So here, type conversion can happen in two ways. They can be explicitly specified by the developer in the code, like, for example, directly calling parseInt, which converts a string, in this example, to an integer, or to string. Or they can be implicitly performed by JavaScript during script execution. This kind of type conversion is typically referred to as type coercion, and type coercion is what we're focusing on today. So why do I have to learn this? Honestly, it's very much built into the language, and it kind of comes with the territory of JavaScript being a dynamically typed language. For example, type coercion is happening even with something as simple as a basic if statement. So in this example, here we know that if successful, value.length will return an integer. So that would be the length of the value. However, the if statement here is expecting a Boolean condition. An integer is not a Boolean. So JavaScript implicitly converts the integer into a Boolean in order to evaluate this expression. Type conversion can also offer more flexibility, and it can be convenient at times, like when you're dealing with user input. And finally, get to know your language better. It's always important to understand what's happening underneath the hood. So let's build some foundational knowledge. Let's talk about converting types. There are two categories of types in JavaScript. So you have the simple types, which are numbers, strings, booleans, the values true and false, null, and undefined. Everything else in JavaScript is an object. So these are arrays and functions, regular expressions, and of course, objects are objects. In the next three slides, I'm going to try to define how JavaScript typically implicitly converts between its different types. And we'll be using this knowledge for the remainder of the talk. So how does JavaScript convert from simple types to numbers? For strings, there's an attempt to parse the string to a number. Otherwise, it returns NaN, or not a number. For Booleans, true is converted to 1, false is converted to 0, positive 0. Null is also converted to positive 0. And undefined is converted to not a number. So what about converting simple types to Booleans? Numbers are converted to true unless the value is positive 0, negative 0, or not a number. These are obviously converted to false. And strings are also converted to true, unless the value is, of course, the empty string, which is converted to false. Null and undefined are both converted to false. And finally, what about objects? How are objects converted? When converting objects to numbers or strings, JavaScript will try to convert the object to a primitive value by implicitly calling value of on the object. Or if value of isn't defined or didn't return a primitive type when called, it will try to call toString on the object instead. Converting objects to Booleans is a bit simpler. They're converted to true. So let's take these guidelines and apply them to a few situations. And let's start with conditional statements first. But let's quickly just make sure we're all on the same page about truth and falsy values in JavaScript. So some examples of values that evaluate to true in JavaScript are the integer 123, or 123, the string smalltalk, the Boolean true, and objects. Some examples of values that evaluate to false in JavaScript are the integer 0, not a number, the empty string, the Boolean false, null, and, of course, undefined. The conditional statements if, for, while, and do while all expect to evaluate Boolean conditions. If the expression does not return a Boolean, its operands are implicitly converted to Booleans using the guidelines that we just defined earlier. So for example, in this example, var value equals document.getElementById smalltalk. GetElementById is a function that looks for an element with a particular ID in the DOM. So it will either return an object if it finds the element, or it will return null. If an object is returned, the if statement will implicitly convert it to true. And if null is returned, the if statement will implicitly convert it to false. So switch statements are a bit special here. Similar to an if statement, they expect to evaluate Boolean conditions. But unlike if statement, when evaluating the switch statements case statements, no type coercion is performed. So in the previous if statement, value was coerced to true or false, depending on whether or not getElementById returned an object or null. Here, value will not be coerced to true or false. It will be treated as its original type. And because of that, it will never satisfy the case statement true, since neither object nor null are equal to the Boolean true. And it will instead enter the default case. Logical operators, which are, of course, and or. Like the conditional operators, logical operators implicitly convert operands to Booleans, depending on the context. But unlike the conditional operators, the operand itself is returned and not the Boolean value. So incidentally, this can be great for setting default values. In this example, var value is equal to 0 or apple. The OR operator is looking from left to right for the first true operand to return. The 0 is converted to false. The string apple is converted to true. And so value is set to the string apple. Mathematical operators, which are, of course, the addition and subtraction signs, the multiplication and division signs, and, of course, the modulo operator. Here, operands are implicitly converted to numbers, except for dates, which for some reason are converted to strings. And in this example, var value is equal to true plus null plus 5. Going from left to right, true is converted to 1, null is converted to 0, and 1 plus 0 plus 5 is, of course, 6. Value is set to 6. The interesting operator to take a look at here is the addition sign. The addition sign is overloaded in JavaScript. So that means that not only can it do addition between two numbers, it can also do string concatenation. So in the case of string concatenation, when one operand is a string and the other operand isn't, the other operand is converted to a string. In this first example, var value is equal to the string smalltalk is plus 2. The value is set to smalltalk is 2 because the integer 2 is converted to a string 2 and then concatenated. But keep in mind that this is happening from left to right. So in the second example, 1 plus 2 are added together because JavaScript isn't aware of the string that follows. And then the 1 plus 2, which is equal to 3, is concatenated to the string smalltalk. And the value that's returned is 3 smalltalk. Relational operator time. And those are greater than, less than, greater than or equal to, and less than or equal to. Similar to the mathematical operators, operands are converted to numbers, but here, even dates are converted to numbers. An exception is that strings are compared via lexicographical string comparison, which just means that characters are compared sequentially, similar to how you might order words in a dictionary. Keep in mind here that any comparison involving not a number will evaluate to false. In this example, var value is equal to false less than the string 123. False is converted to 0, the string 123 is converted to 123, and value is set to true, because of course, 0 is less than 123. Now for the more meaty stuff, equality operators. But let's quickly go over what equality means in JavaScript. Values are considered equal if they are identical Boolean values. So true is equal to true, but it's not equal to false. If they're identical strings, the string ABC is equal to the string ABC, but not to, say, ABCD. They're also considered equal if they're numerically equivalent numbers. 1 is equal to 1. And I also wanted to note that positive 0 is equal to negative 0 in this case. And values are considered equal if they're obviously the same object. And again, not a number is special here. It's not equal to anything, including itself. And as you all probably know, there are two sets of equality operators in JavaScript, the double equals operator and the triple equals operator. The double equals operator compares for equality after doing any necessary type coercions if it determines that the types are different. The double equals operator follows what's known as the abstract equality comparison algorithm, which is a series of 22 steps that it uses to determine equality. So when the expression meets one of the step conditions, JavaScript will return true or false accordingly. Otherwise, if it reaches the end of this series, it will return false. We'll get into a bit more detail about how type coercions are performed here, but first, let's walk through an example. So var value is equal to null greater than or equal to 0. Using the knowledge that we obtained about relational operators, this seems pretty straightforward. The relational operator implicitly converts to numbers. So null will be converted to 0. And of course, 0 is greater than or equal to 0. So value is set to true. But let's look at another example. Var value is equal to null, double equals 0. This returns false. What the hell? How does that make sense? Everything we've learned so far implies that null would be converted to 0 here. But in short, null is treated in a special way by the double equals operator. It only coerces to undefined. This is only one of the many strange cases that involve the double equals operator. But this is all due to and can be explained by following the abstract equality comparison algorithm. So the abstract equality comparison algorithm is defined really quite clearly in the ECMAScript language specifications. I don't want to overwhelm or bore you with all 22 steps, but I did want to kind of walk through what happens after JavaScript has determined that the two types are different and attempts to type coerce, which are incidentally steps 14 through 22 in the algorithm. Null equals undefined. Null is equal to undefined, sorry. And if one operand, and the next step is, if one operand is a string and the other operand is a number, the string will be implicitly converted to a number. If one of the operands is a Boolean, the Boolean will be implicitly converted to a number. And if one of the operands is a string or a number, and the other operand is an object, the object will be implicitly converted to a primitive. So the triple equals operator behaves similarly to the double equals operator, except no type coercion is done. It uses the strict equality comparison algorithm, which is nearly identical to the first 13 steps of the abstract equality comparison algorithm, but obviously leaves out all the bits related to type coercion. Types must be the same initially in order to be considered equal. Otherwise, the triple equals operator will return false. Since there are no unexpected type coercions being done, when using the triple equals operator, we can have more faith in the results, and it can be much safer. So one neat tool I came across while I was preparing for my talk was this JavaScript equality table. It graphically displays the results of comparisons using the double equals and triple equals operator. So green means expression evaluated to true. White means expression evaluated to false. So in conclusion, I want to leave you all with a few tips. Try to favor the triple equals operator over the doubles equal operator. As I mentioned earlier, it can be dangerous to use the double equals operator if you're not sure what you're doing. Try to perform explicit type conversion when you're able to do so. So that was from my earlier slide, calling parse int or toString. And use the JavaScript console and the ECMAScript language specifications as resources. This talk was meant to provide foundational knowledge of type coercion in JavaScript, but it's, of course, missing details. The ECMAScript language specification goes into this in depth and is surprisingly actually not too terrible of a read. Thanks, guys. Come chat with me later if you'd like to discuss any of this or tell me about your dogs.